Harold's always trying his best to sneak down there with the kids. I tell you what. I think Psalm chapter 40. Let me see here. Yeah. You just lay this here. I want us to ask ourselves a few questions this morning. How many times, for instance, do we go to the Lord in prayer? Hopefully it's on a daily basis, but we ask God many things, and maybe I'm sure a lot of us will ask, "Your will be done, Lord. Not my will, but your will be done." Many people will pray for something, and if it does not come to pass, almost as soon as they get done praying, they begin to doubt. If you begin to doubt and waver in your faith, you will end up being exactly like the Bible says, unstable in all of your ways, because people that are we end up being tossed to and fro just like a wave is upon the sea. Sometimes when things are going our way, it's very easy to believe in God. When things are going exactly how we want, it's very easy to say we are blessed. When we are up on the mountain, which is everything going our way, we tend to be happy, and there's nothing wrong with that. And we tend to trust God and talk well of God. But church, I will guarantee you that even when the bottom drops out from underneath us, so to speak, in our life, and life becomes chaos, and we find ourselves in the valley as low as we can be, God will assure you and guarantee you that God is still God. That God is still there in that valley the same way He was and is upon the mountaintops. Because the God of the mountain is still God in the valley. But our attitude seems to change depending on what is going on in our lives. Have you ever asked God for patience? Has anybody here ever prayed unto the Lord to give them patience? If you have, get ready for one of the hardest times that you will ever face in your life. I have asked God for patience, and I have went through, it seems like, everything a person can go through just to be able to say, now I am a patient man. And still, some things do irk me, of course. For instance, stupidity. They don't make a pill for me to be able to take and accept stupidity. I just don't like it. But it's everywhere we've looked today. But anyways, common sense has been thrown away a long time ago. If you put your faith in any man behind any pulpit, I will be the first to say your faith lies in the wrong person. Your faith should be, ought to be, has to be, and better be in God Almighty. No man whatsoever. Because there's no man that can give eternal life other than God Almighty through and by His only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, which came into this world to die one time for all, to make a sin covering, a sacrifice for sin for all. He will never die again. Now, we ask God for patience, for instance, like I was getting ready to say. And then it seemed like the world just turns completely upside down. And we fall into having attitudes, fall into having stress, fall into having strife, contentions with people, because things are not going our way whatsoever. As a matter of fact, when you pray, or if you pray for patience from the Lord God, you will have to go through much in this world to actually be able to have the patience that you have asked for. God says, ask and you and you shall receive. So if you do not want it, do not ask. If you do not want to the door to be opened up unto you, do not knock. If you do not want to find it, do not seek for it. But I would advise you to ask, knock, and seek for it. We are to get wisdom with our getting when it comes to the Word of God. Many people have wisdom. I will not deny that, even when it comes to the Word of God. But they lack the most important thing. With thy wisdom, get understanding. If we cannot understand the Word of God, it does us no good. We can never be able to sit down, open up the Bible, and read it like we would read a newspaper and think that we can understand the Word of God. If we are in the world and not serving God, there's an excellent chance you will not be able to understand it anyways, because the Bible is light and the world and the people in it are darkness. Guess what darkness cannot do? It cannot comprehend the light. So therefore, and I seen a question the other day, does God answer every prayer? Depends on who's doing the praying. If you're a child of God, absolutely, He hears each and every one of your prayers, and He will indeed answer every one of our prayers according to His will. And He will do it for His glory, and He will do it at the time it needs to be done. We should not want to rush God, but many times we do. We should not want to try to do God's job, but many times we do. We want to get in God's way, fumble everything, mess it all up, and then have to start all over again. But if you are not a child of God, rest assured, your prayers are not being heard from the beginning. God does not hear a sinner's prayer. But if we can't stop there, but if a person repents unto the Lord and opens up his heart unto the Lord and comes to accept God into his life and is born again, God has then made through his Holy Spirit and through the blood of his Son Jesus a brand new creature out of that person. And from that day forward, rest assured, God does indeed hear your prayer. Now, we have a problem most of the time. I want to read one verse here in chapter 40 of the book of Psalms. And this is David, to my knowledge. He is actually praying or giving God praise for answered prayer. Verse 8 says, I delight to do thy will, O my God. Yea, thy law is within my heart. Many of us have no delight whatsoever in today's world. When I say many of us, if you need to take it personally, by all means do so. But I'm not here to talk to one individual and point out to anything to one person or anything like that. When I say most of us, I am referring to people all around the world in today's world. It seems like most of the people that even call themselves Christians today, make no mistake about it, church, before I go any further, God knows who are His, and God also knows those who are not His, but are indeed the workers of the devil. Well, you can fool me all of the time. Some of you can, most likely. Some of you can fool me some of the time, maybe. But God, nobody can fool God at any time. God knows all. He is all-wise God. And many people in today's walkway of life are completely opposite from what David is saying here. He's saying, Lord, I delight to do your will. I'm happy to do your will. First of all, what is the will of God? People say, I want to be within the will of God. You will have to do only one thing, and one thing, let me take that back. First of all, you will have to have faith in God, because without faith, it will be absolutely impossible to please God. So if there's no faith behind what you ask God, don't waste your time asking God for it, because nothing will change. Nothing will come to pass. And second of all, I'm reminded over in the book of Samuel, when Saul was told by Samuel himself, a good prophet of God, a brother, one of the best prophets of God that I have ever read about in the Word of God thus far, although each and every one had their own downfall, because each and every person in the world, all have sinned and come short, have they not, of the glory of God? But Saul was told by Samuel, the man of God, to go over and into a city and to slay every man, woman, boy, and girl, a beast and ox and everything else, and children, each and everything. He was told to go over there and just kill them all, or wipe them out. Why would God do that? First of all, church, it's not my position to ask God, why do you want me to do it? Although if I were to ask, a brother, he tells us right there, because of their continued wickedness, they are evil. Don't worry about the children. They're in the hands of God. I do not want them, the Lord said, to grow up and be like the ones that are surrounding them. I just rid by me of all of them. But Saul did not do that. He went over there and he killed a few, yet, but he saved a whole bunch of things as far as animals that looked good to him, did he not? And he brought them back, and he wanted, and he sacrificed them unto the Lord God. That's why he brought him back. And here come old Samuel, did he not? And say, Saul, have you been obedient to the word of God? That's the second thing we're going to have to do. We're going to have to be obedient unto what saith the word of God. Not just want to be. Not just say we hope we can. We can indeed. Church, no matter what you believe in your heart, no matter what you think, if you're a born again child of God, you have the power to do all thing through Christ that gives you and I strength. We can't do anything without God. Many people think they can, but I'm here to tell you, I can't even walk without God's hand holding on to mine. I can't even breathe without God giving me that air. I can't even get out of the bed. I can't even open my eyes, but many times without the mercy of God. But I thought, I'll tell you something, many people are wrapped up today in their own self, in their own so-called power, in their own so-called might. They think with their, all of their heart, by my hand, in their own mind, have I gotten me this and have I gotten me that? But I'll tell you right now, without God, you don't have anything. Even if you're walking around living in today's world, if you do not have the Lord in your heart, you are just as good as dead in God's eyes. Even though we live, we're as good as dead in God's eyes if we don't have the Holy Spirit of God within us, and if we do not have the blood of Jesus applied. Being a Christian is not something we say. It's something that we live. It's something that we do. Love is not what I say. Love is what I do. God said, I love you. But God did not stop there, did he? He showed you and I. It's not about what we say. Brother, the devil and the soothsayers have all kinds of beautiful words they can whisper in our ears, but none of them are true whatsoever. How do you know that, preacher? Because the devil is a liar and the father of it. Every time the devil opens his mouth, you can believe with all of your heart, he is doing nothing but telling you a lie and whispering a lie to you. But the devil comes in great forms, does he not? He comes in a form of light, if we allow him to. And brother, he comes in even a form of God in many times. And people are following him. They've gotten away today from the very word of God, which is life everlasting. And apart from God's word, there is no life whatsoever. whatsoever. Apart from the word of God, there is no life in this life, now nor in the life to come. Yes, we're all going to live forever one way or the other, because God designed you and I to live forever with Him. Oh, but in the very beginning, mankind got away from God, did he not? Listen to the one that was deceived, did he not? And the devil came with a cool voice, did he not? And acting like he was all of that. And he came up to the woman, did he not? Yo, did God say this and that? And Brother E fell right into it. And then before you know it, a wall of partition called sin went up between man and God. Oh, but I thank God to know when the world was destroyed, church, by water and a flood that covered half of the highest mountain, so many feet, that brother, there was people that found grace in the eyes of God, and his name was Noah, praise God. A little preacher at that time that would move with fear, even though he did not see what God was talking about at that time. He did not see anything, but brother, he still listened to God. He was obedient unto what saith the Lord his God, and he had a desire, apparently, did he not, to do the will of God. That's the problem with the world today. We want people to follow us all over the world, but brother, we better be in a position to where we are following Jesus Christ. If we're following a preacher, we better do away with that. That preacher ain't done a thing for me except preach the word of God. And brother, don't get me wrong, I thank God and give him praise, honor, and glory for people that will stand up today in this old dreadful world, in this old sinful world, and preach the word of God. But that man can't give me everlasting life. Nobody but Jesus himself, a God Almighty, through the blood of his Son. Jesus Christ is the answer. That's the way, the truth, and the life. He's the only way. He's the only Messiah. Brother, he's the first and the last. He is everything that you and I need. The one thing that the whole world needs is God and Jesus Christ. Oh, but the world is turning into every other thing known unto man, is it not? It's time to put away all of the things. A church that's so easily beset. You and I, if we want to get in the glory, brother, well, glory, church, we need to stand firm upon the word of God. And I'll tell you one thing, don't back down from the word of God when the people come to you. And don't you never think it may not happen, because in this walkway of life, the Lord told me already, in this world you shall have troubles and sorrow and trials. And brother, in this world you will have no peace, but I will give you peace that the world cannot give unto you. In Jesus Christ alone, mankind will find peace. So do away with all of the peace talk and praying for world peace. It ain't going to happen. It flat out is not going to happen. As long as we are in this world, we are going to have sorrow. The Lord made this very clear while he was down here in this world. But he said, but be ye of good cheer. I have overcome the world. I have overcome the world. And because he lives, you and I can live also. We've taken too much granted of God and what he has done in our lives today. And I will speak to the whole world with that statement right there, to every Christian around the world, including myself. Absolutely. I preach it to myself, as the Apostle Paul says, so that I'm not a castaway. Excuse me a minute while I get this tickle in my throat gone, I hope. David had a delight to do God's will. People today say, I want to do God's will. What is God's will? We have to sum that up. We have to get to the bottom of that, won't we? To find out. I want to do God's will. Well, that's good. What is God's will? I don't know. People are in that position. I have no clue. You don't know what God's will is for you? No. God's will for him is this. God's will for her is that. But I don't know what God's will is for me. God's will for all of mankind is the same thing. To come unto him before it's everlasting too late. To have faith in him. To believe in his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. And have everlasting life with God the Father in heaven after this life. If we can believe that there is no God, that's our prerogative. God gives us that opportunity. He gives us free will. And many people do indeed say there is no such thing as a God, but when he comes, there will be no atheist found. Amen. Not one. Amen. Every knee will indeed bow, every eye will indeed look upon, every tongue will indeed confess unto God the Father that Jesus is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Like it or not, believe it or not, want it or not, you will be there. You will not miss this event. It will be a worldwide event, and it will be the end of the world event. Regardless of what doctor or philosopher so-and-so may preach unto you, when the Lord comes, it's over, just like the flood. When the flood came, it was all over. The door had been shut by the hand of God. That mercy door was shut. They could beg, plead, cry all they want. Didn't do them a thing. Noah was in it with his wife, his three sons and their wives, and all of the animals that God led to Noah. And brother, that was it. Once God closed and shut them in, it was all over. The day is the day of salvation. If you hear the voice of God, don't harden your heart against him. If God allows you and I to hear the word of God more than once, we are privileged. We have been honored. We have been shown the mercy of God. We have been shown the grace of God, because God's only obligated to cause all of the world to hear his word one time, and then we could die and be lost forever without him. We need to understand what the will of God is. I hope I just summed it up. To know him, to be obedient unto him, to please him. God's will in our life is he desires a good ending for you and I. And he has good plans for you and I. Nothing that is evil comes is of God. Many things that are evil are allowed, but God is not the one that's behind it all. God oversees everything. He allows things or he does not allow things. For instance, Job was allowed by the hand of Satan, was he not, to be tested, tempted? And Satan was allowed to take everything that Job had. Satan even got Job's own wife to turn against him and said, Job, why don't you just call it a day already? Why don't you just quit already? Why don't you just curse God already and just die and get it over with? Just get it over with, Job. You don't have to do all of this. Just go ahead and curse God and die and get it over with. He looked at his wife and said, you talk as a foolish woman. Amen. You talk as a foolish woman. Shall I accept blessings from God, but not accept all of the other things? The good Lord gives, the good Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And regardless, if the good Lord took one of my children, being who I am now, before they was grown, I would understand what has taken place. I would be able to rejoice because one day I will see them again. I don't have to think about it. Don't have to pray for them anymore. Yes, I would miss them in this world. Yes, I would be heartbroken as far as literally and physically. But at the same time, the Spirit of God would get me through all of it, and he would give me the grace to continue on by his grace, because his grace is sufficient for me. And is it not? Because I remember the words when they was crying for the Lord, when he was on his way to Calvary to lay his life down. They were weeping and crying for him. And he said, don't weep for me, but weep for yourselves and weep for your children. For the days will come that they will say, blessed are the paths that never gave suck. And church, I know what he's talking about. In today's world, it's nothing but evil when we bring children into it. We can expect that brother, if they're allowed to grow up at all, they're going to be surrounded by hatred. They're going to be surrounded by evil. They're going to be surrounded by all of these things, because God is continuing, as far as in this old world, to be pushed aside and pushed aside until there's no God left in anything. Because church, we can even go into church houses and places of worship in today's world, and everything is so programmed up. God's Holy Spirit cannot be found. God's Holy Spirit is not present, but man wants it that way. We can get people in here to put on the big old rock show, a big old Christian something show, whatever you call it, and brother, pretend we're on stage and make the make songs of the world and bring the world in. But I'll tell you one thing, if God's not in it, it don't matter how big the congregation is. It don't mean anything to the Lord thy God. I'm not in the preaching the word of God to tickle people's fancy. I'm not into preaching the word of God to make people happy. I'm into preaching the word of God for my very life. I'm into preaching the word of God to see souls come into the kingdom of God and be added into his fold before it's everlasting too late. So thank God to know, church, no matter what goes on in our life, if you're a child of God, notice I said that, if you're a child of God, that don't mean if you know about God, the devil knows all about it. I said if you are a child of God, no matter what goes on in your life, you continue to praise God with your lips. It's my cross, many people say, I have to carry it. Let me tell you something. I know the Lord says, I bring division. I bring a sword to put between them, their mother, the mother against the daughter, the father against the son, and so forth. But I'll tell you something. That simply means the household is going to be all divided a lot of times, not every time, but a lot of times, because people will come into the kingdom of God, maybe a husband or a wife, and the other one won't. And then you're going to have problems right there, and Satan's going to see to it. Satan's going to see to it. But it's not God that's doing it. It's not God that's doing it. God wants you and I, he brings peace. I know division is involved in many things. The world loves its own. The world knows how to give good gifts unto its own. But I'm here to proclaim Jesus Christ loved the world. God loved the world so much that he gave his only begotten Son. John chapter 3, verse 16. For God loved the world so much, or so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. I can believe. I can still believe in God and perish. That's why it says should not perish. The devil believes in God, does he not? I don't feel I need to go over that over and over and over. But if I do feel I need to do it, I'll do it. But the devil knows all about God. The devil can quote scripture upon scripture. Don't take my word for it. He did it unto Jesus himself. If thou be the Son of God, cast thyself down from here, for it is written, the devil said, God shall give his angels charge over thee, lest at any time thou dash thy foot against the stone. And he said, if thou be the son of God, command this stone to be made bread. But God, because he was hungry, fasted for 40 days and 40 nights. Notice when, getting ready to wrap it up, notice when Jesus was tested and tempted and tried. Right after he got baptized. Right after he got baptized, here come the devil. Well, we can't have this. So listen, church. If you proclaim that you have given your life unto the Lord God, you expect the devil to start trying his best to hang out with you more than he ever has, because that's what he does. Hey, you, proclaiming to this and proclaiming to that, you messed up, you slipped. You're not anything you proclaim to be. I told you. That's nothing but a lie from the pits of hell. Don't you believe it? We all make mistakes. We all fall and come short of the glory of God. But God is full of mercy, full of grace, full of long-suffering, full of truth. And guess what else God is? He is faithful. He will finish what He started. Now, I'm not here to tell you to get into the habit of cursing every time you turn around or saying things you ought not to every time you turn around and fall into that category or the habit of saying, Lord, forgive me. You do it 15 minutes later, Lord, forgive me. God's not in that nonsense. God's not in that nonsense, and you'll not mock God and get away with it. I guarantee you that. But we, as Christians today, we need to have a delight in doing God's will. God's will is what He desires, what He would have, what He wants. And let's face it, church, what God wants and what God would have and what God desires, is it anything bad for anybody in this world? Absolutely not. It's only good. He wants everlasting life for all of mankind. God has no pleasure whatsoever in seeing wicked people die without Him. He's made the way. He laid the pavement down. He built that road, and He built it with one cross and three nails and unconditional love. I've heard many times, one cross plus three nails equals four given. But you know what? The love of God and the sacrifice done on that cross is what I'm interested in. Not the cross and the nails per se themselves. I have to carry a cross, and so does every other Christian. Because our Savior did it, so shall we. If they hated Him, they will hate you and I. But I am so thankful to know that it's God's will that everyone come to know Him before they lay their life down in this world, that they can have everlasting life after this world is over. God has made that way. That way is Jesus Christ and Him crucified, and we can't stop there. Better yet, and rose from the dead. Had He not rose, He'd be just like any other false god. But He rose from the dead. He holds all power in heaven and in earth. Death, hell, and the grave, He has victory over it all. So therefore, so do you and I. Our God is a loving God, but He's also a judging God. God will indeed come back, and He will indeed judge all of mankind. He will judge us according as our works shall be. Over in the book of Revelation again. Don't take my word for it. Behold, I come quickly, saith the Lord, and my reward is with me to give unto every man according as his works shall be. As we stand, do you have a delight in serving the Lord? Do you want God's will to be done in your life? Or do you pray and say that, and then when God's will is trying to be done in your life, we push it away?